Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. It's been quite a while since I uploaded anything, and today we are going to discuss the ORBEA Wild FS. My ORBEA Wild FS. It's been about a year since I got it, and I've put on more than 2,000 kilometers on it. And why don't I give you a tour and a few tips and tricks and just my opinion of the bike. Let's go. Okay guys, so overall it's been my main bike over the last year. I still have two other mountain bikes. I've got the Polygon D7 Siskiyou, full suspension, 120 mil kind of trail bike or cross country, down country bike. And I have a Marine Bobcat Trail 4 as a hardtail. So anytime when I wanna kind of under bike, I take one of those two acoustic bikes for a ride, but most of the times I just ride the Wild. And the Wild is definitely wild. So let's discuss it from front to back. Tires. On the tires, it's got the Maxxis Minion DHF in the front and DHR in the back. And those are just awesome tires. This is what the front looks like after 2001 kilometers. And this is what the back looks like. A little more used. Also put in a plug in the tire about 1,000 kilometers ago, and it's still holding air fine. I keep riding the tire. I think around 2500 is when I'm going to replace it. So that's the tires. Brakes are 203 millimeter rotors on four piston Shimano calipers. These are just awesome brakes. If you've seen EMTB video's introduction of this model at 2020, he was saying, and he showed that the rear had a 180. So for 2021, they moved it up to 203. And they just work great. I'm still on the original pads, about 2,100 kilometers. Still some meat there to go. Again, 2,500, I think, is when I'm gonna do the big replacement on this bike. Suspension is RockShox both ends, 35 millimeter air shock, air fork in the front. It's got adjustability and lockout, rebound and compression damping, air fill out on this side. Rebound is on the bottom, and I really like it. The rear shock is the same adjustability. And about 200 PSI on the back, roughly, I think it's like 80 or so in the front for me. And you can see that I don't quite use the whole travel yet. Frame, this is the extra large frame. I am 6 feet tall, 183 centimeters width, roughly a shorter inseam. I think it's about 31 inches. So this comes originally with a 170 mil dropper, and I replaced it when I bought the bike at the shop for 150. And as you can see, the crown here is sitting just at the top. There's no space, and I'm using the full length, the 150 mil, and it's perfect for my size. So anyone thinking about this bike and you're my size, 6 feet, 183 millimeters, extra large is probably your size. Someone could go with a large, but I feel awesome on this extra large. Motor, the Bosch Performance CX, 85 newton meters, 250 watt, continuous. This is the European model, and zero issues with the motor. It's been going great. The display, let me show you. This is the 2021 model, so of course it's got the EMTB. Echo is 55% addition to your own power. You move up to Tour, that's 120% extra. When you go up to EMTB, that's all the way up to 200% power assistance. And when you go to Turbo, that's 300% assistance over your power. So I think in 2022, they went up on the Turbo to 340. And then even later that year, they offered the super extra strong competition model that gave you 400% assistance. So this one goes all the way only up to 300% on the Turbo. That's plenty enough. I mostly use just the Eco, and then when it gets hard, I push it up to Tour and I feel like Hercules. That's good enough for me. Cockpit ergonomics, handlebars are 780 mil. Again, almost perfect for me. I think I would have preferred just slightly shorter, maybe 760, but 780s are good. I replaced the grips to ergon ones with a little cushion at the end. Here are the brake calipers and the brake levers, Shimano. They're just awesome. The dropper and the Dior shifter. And of course, the rear has the XT rear derailleur. 12 speed, I think it's 11 to 51. I really like this crevice right here in the frame because you can drop a spare or a backup tube right in there and you can strap it down, you know, with a wide Velcro strap. And here, I got one to show you. One of these, they're available on Amazon, lube Benzer, and you just strap it around and the strap holds in, you know, the closure for the battery. So it's a win-win situation. Just awesome. The seat, well, this isn't the stock seat. This is just a seat I fell in love with. It's the WTB Silverado. And I moved it up to this bike because the stock seat is just horrible. There's no relief channel, nothing. It's just stock there. And after like 20 kilometers of off-road riding, you really start screaming uncle because it's bad. So any other seat you choose would probably be better than the stock seat. This little $1 mud flap I put on there from AliExpress, it does the job, keeps most of the spray off my back when we ride in mud. Well guys, that's my bike, that's my experience. Please put out down in the comments any questions or any of your experience with this bike, if you own it or if you're thinking of buying it. I'll try to answer each and every question, respond. This is the ORBEA Wild FS 160 millimeter suspension e-bike, a 2021 model in extra large, and I just love it. Thanks. See you on the next video.